So if I was to explain to an audience member what exactly Lab OM is or what the story is about, I would have to refer to a very interesting quote from Antonio Papano, who's the director of opera at Covent Garden, where he referred to Lab OM recently as the Friends of 1896. And by Friends, he's referring to the American sitcom. And that is exactly what Lab OM can be depicted to be to any audience member. It's of some young students, bohemians, who have the hardship of poverty, who have the hardship of falling in love, have the hardship of illness. They also have all the joys that are associated with all of those as well. It's typical of Puccini's style in his later style, or mid to late style, of Verismo opera, where there is a very real and true story that tells of all of the elements of life, really. And I suppose it just makes it that bit more open to follow, as you would a story in the cinema, maybe, at the same time. I think Bohème is an excellent example of an opera suitable for concert performance, mainly because of the style of Puccini's musical writing, in the sense that he is really a painter or an illustrator of the soundscape that you hear. So you're never left bereft of a thought of what landscape Puccini's trying to show or express within the scene. Through the chorus in La Bohème, in Act 2, their role is almost scenic. We hear the cries of Parpignol, the performer. We hear the cries of the street vendors, the apple sellers, the plum sellers, the prostitutes, the hawkers, the guards. We are in no doubt that we are in the Latin Quarter of Paris in the late 1890s, and that the principal characters are within and contained within that kind of scenic chorus role. For a concert goer, then, when you don't have the scenery around you and the costumes and all the paraphernalia that goes with a full opera production, you're still exposed completely to the integrity of the musical piece. The musical motifs really enunciate the type of characters that you're dealing with. We see this kind of really, you know, a life that's full of deficits, but they actually make the best out of it. So, I mean, similarly to the sitcom, I suppose that was the comedy in the sitcom, really. All the tribulations of the cast members, and similarly for La Bohème, people think it's quite comedic. As well as the fact that it's a love story and it's a tragedy, it is actually very funny at the same time.